There's one that you might be super interested in.
Are you talking about Light No Fire?
That's right.
Yes, Hello Games entry this year.
Yeah, that came out of nowhere. That sucker punched me out just like, what?
It's looking real good.
It looks really cool. And it's like, you know, Hello Games, these boys, yeah. They don't sit on their...
Yeah, no, apparently this has been like Sean Murray's secret project for the last 5 years, but it's a single player, or no, it's multiplayer. Sorry, it's a single world, procedurally generated world adventure. It looks like they took No Man's Sky assets and just reskinned some things. Like there's like rabbit creatures running around that they took off on a giant bird in this trailer, which was looking awesome. But it all felt a lot like No Man's Sky. And I had to wonder how much of this game being... this secret project all this time might be them trying to work out how to make one planet in No Man's Sky very specific. And I wonder how much on their back end, how much of this world they've made for this whole entire other game, if they are able to just like plug it into No Man's Sky and make it one of the worlds in there. And if not, I want it to be like that. That's what they're really going for here. But it looks good.
Interesting.
Light No Fire.
This would be kind of like a launching, like, they released this game, but it also, like, connects to No Man's Sky?
Well, or this is like a template prototype they've worked out for how to make a planet into its own whole adventure. Like, customize a planet. Because the planet itself has procedural generation going on. They've got to be using some of their same technology and game engine stuff that they've built over these years for No Man's Sky, right? One can't not be helping the other, is what I'm saying. No Man's Sky, even if the stories aren't specifically connected, the games themselves, the software, one cannot be not helping the other with this kind of thing.
Oh, yeah, totally, totally. Yeah,
I wouldn't be surprised.
It looks really fun, where it's just like, okay, let's get all these players, let's put them on a big-ass planet, but this planet is, like, to actual scale.
Yeah, like, if it's the size of one of the No Man's Sky planets that is just full of stuff to do... and specific quest lines and storylines and like this rabbit race of people and some birds to fly on. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. But I wouldn't be surprised if we start seeing more stuff like this in No Man's Sky too, following this game.
My thought immediately goes to, so how are players going to break the game?
Oh yeah.
As quickly as possible. Because I remember when No Man's Sky, when it first launched and they were saying like, yeah, it's a procedurally generated world. And players are all across this universe, and it's this one same universe, and we highly doubt it'll take years.
Nobody will ever meet.
Yeah. And it's like a few days after.
Yeah.
Some players were just like, we did it.
We did it.
And there's no multiplayer. We can't even interact with each other. But we're on the same planet.
Yeah. Oh, so, man. No Man's Sky before multiplayer.
I'm just curious about, hopefully those guys, they... take initiatives to actually, because people being on one big planet, you know, gamers can be jerks. And
yeah,
they can do some jerk stuff.
There's some interesting base building animations going on in this trailer too. Speaking of the multiplayer part, yeah, I hope the but they've ironed out a lot of those kinks. I think with No Man's Sky, they've got these anti-griefing practices in No Man's Sky that I feel like everything they've done in No Man's Sky would be so easily applicable to this. Single planet adventure.
Right. And so we can go, like, we can, like, start, a Gepnik nation.
I'm gonna go out on a limb here and call it right now. The ending of this game, the super secret final 100% ending of this game, you're gonna encounter the Atlas from No Man's Sky and possibly leave this planet and realize you're in the No Man's Sky universe. I'm just gonna put that out there. I'm gonna call it right now. That's the ending of this game. We'll find out. I don't think it comes out for a while. 2024? Is it a 24 release?
I don't think it says.
Oh, no release date. It does have a Steam page. No word yet on release date. Okay.
Yeah.
We'll see. I'm going to call the ending right now, and I feel pretty confident in that call. Just saying. No release date. But that's Light No Fire from Hello Games. Looking real promising. Real promising. I'll say that. I am excited for that one.
It definitely makes me want to, you know, boot up No Man's Sky.
Yeah, actually, Junior just fired it up today. They're doing the replay of 2023's Expeditions, where you can play the Expeditions over and get the rewards if you missed them this year. So, No Man's Sky players, now's your chance. Get those Expeditions done. That's also happening with No Man's Sky right now.
There you go.
Yeah. Light No Fire. What other trailers did we see?